Good.
After our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth.
So is it referring to us, meaning we are all not just a mirror, or not in the image of God, but we are all part of God, or we all are God?
Well, let's see. We don't have to guesstimate. Let's go back and read. See, I'm glad. It's beautiful that you said that, brother. We don't have to guesstimate. Let's go. Who's Patrick? Just came in. Let's go back to the precept that we just read aforehand. Go back and read that again, Yashubim, to answer JD's question.
Book of Proverbs, chapter 8, verse 23. I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning.
Okay, stop. So who was back there in the beginning? Him. HaMashiach. Yahusha. He said, I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning. Go ahead.
Forever the earth was.
Read on.
Verse 24. When there were no depths.
When there was no waters.
I was brought forth.
Mm-hmm.
When there was no fountains abounding with water.
Mm-hmm. Read on.
Verse 25. Before the mountains were settled. Before the hills. Was I brought forth?
This can't be talking about Solomon or David, but whoever this is talking about, they came out of the seed line of David. Hallelujah, yo. He's talking about HaMashiach. Yahushua. Go ahead, read on.
Verse 26. While as yet he had not made the earth, nor
well, what'd you say? He has what?
While as he had not made the earth.
See, JD, he hadn't even made the Eretz. Go ahead.
Nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world. When he prepared the heavens, I was there.
So he can't be talking about us, as you saying, JD, as the whole body of people, man. He said, mm-hmm. I. That's possessive now. I was there.
But we are
David wasn't there. Solomon wasn't there.
But you're part of him.
Mashiach. HaMashiach was there. I wasn't there. I know I wasn't there.
Oh, yeah, you were.
Go ahead. JD's about to go into a different topic, man. Go ahead. Let's get this out. Let's stay in the spirit. Let's get this out, man.
When he set a compass.
Because JD can listen to it later, man. Let's get it out.
When he set a compass upon the face of the depth. When he established the clouds above. When he strengthened the fountains of the deep. When he gave to the sea his decree. That the water should not pass his commandment, when he appointed the fountains of the earth. Then I was by him, as one brought up with him, and I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him, rejoicing in the habitable part of his earth, and my delights were with the sons of men.
Mm-hmm. Now, let me ask you a question, JD. Does Yahuwah have a son?
Yeah, I believe he has many sons.
No. Okay, I got to be very specific with you, my brother. Does he have an only begotten son? Now, how many sons that he say is only begotten? Let me put it that way. Can't tap dance around that one, JD.
How many
begotten sons does he have?
Can you claim a begotten? How you define?
Let's
begotten?
Let's go to Proverbs. Back to Proverbs. We're gonna go to 30, and we're gonna read verse 4. Let's see if he has a son. Where's my readers at, man? What you guys, falling asleep? You can't fall asleep on this word, man. Better stand in spirit. Kadar's out, isn't he?
Gone. Snooze. What's the precept, Buck?
In the midst Proverbs, of the world. Proverbs 34.
Proverbs 34. Who hath ascended up into heaven or descended?
Okay, stop. Who's that? Who's that talking about, JD? Who ascended? That's not talking about no Elijah. Before you say Elijah, it is not talking about Elijah. When he was taken up, he didn't come back down. Fact. Who ascended and then descended? Go ahead, read.
Who have gathered the wind in his fist.
Now, first was talking about Yahusha. The second is talking about Yahuwah. He gathered the wind in his fist. Read on.
Who has bound the waters in a garment.
Mm-hmm.
Who hath established all the ends of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
What is his name and what is his son's name?
What is what?
His son's name.
That's possessive. His son. What is his name? What is his son's name? So he does have a son. Go ahead.
If thou canst tell.
If thou canst tell, JD. If thou canst tell. Still not convinced? So it's imperative that I address a few things here. Talking about begotten son, and JD, he tap dance around that. Now I know he speaks the Ibri, so he asked what was meant by the word begotten, and I know he knew what that meant. The Ibri word for begotten is kana, that's possessive. It means to acquire, right? This is kana. This is the Ibrit word, right? Kana, to acquire, to beget, right? Now, so the begotten son. Now, I also read who was taken up into Shemaiah. Let's get that. Paul was talking about that in the book of Acts. Book of Acts 1, verse 9 through 11. And now, he has spoken these things. While they watch, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. Verse 10. And while they looked steadfastly towards the Shemayims, the heavens, as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel. Verse 11. And who also said, quote, men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing up into the heaven? This same HaMashiach, Yahusha, who was taken up from you into Shemayim, heaven, will soon come in like manner as you saw him go. Now that right there is going to be fulfilled with Revelations 19 and 11. Now the other thing I wanted to address is JD kind of reminds me of a doubting Thomas. Remember, Thomas would always doubt. And there was a precept we read back there, and JD alluded to that could have been anyone because many people was crucified, right? So we're going to show you this was specifically referring to HaMashiach, Yahusha, right? Book of Yochanan, start reading at 20, verse 20. And when he had said, and when he had so said, he showed unto them his hands and his side. Remember, his hand and his feet got pierced, and his side got pierced. Who's talking here? This is Yochanan talking about HaMashiach, Yahusha, the real Messiah, the anointed high priest, the anointed Kohen of Israel. You understand? Then the disciples glad when they saw Adonai. Then said Yahusha to them again, peace be unto you. As my Abba, my Father, have sent me, even so send I you. And when he had said this, his brethren, he breathed on them and saith unto them, receive the Ruach HaKadosh. So he blew the Holy Spirit onto them. Whosoever sins ye remit, they are remitted unto them. And whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was with them, was not with them when Yahusha HaMashiach came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, we have seen Adonai. But he said unto them, except I see his hands, and this kind of reminds me of you, good brother, JD. You're tapped into the wrong, just like a doubting Thomas. Thomas said, except I see in his hands the prints of the nails, and put my fingers into the prints of the nails, and thrust my hands in his side, I will not believe. It's kind of like you, JD. Verse 26. And after 8 days, again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came